Whether you are a seasoned developer or just starting your coding journey, the concept of scope in JavaScript is a topic that demands your attention. So, what is scope in JavaScript? Well, at its core, JavaScript scope refers to the context or environment in which variables are declared and can be accessed. It dictates the visibility and lifetime of a variable, determining where in your code a particular variable is valid and accessible. First of all, scope is not a mere technicality. It profoundly influences the way you structure your code, manage your data, and prevent conflicts between variables. A lack of understanding of scope can lead to bugs, unexpected behaviors, and increased maintenance efforts, all of which can be avoided with proper comprehension and application of scope rules. Further, JavaScript offers various types of scope, with three primary ones being global, local, and block scope. Each of these scopes control the accessibility of variables in different parts of your code and play a pivotal role in maintaining code organization and preventing variable conflicts. So, let's start with an example. Imagine your JavaScript code as a bustling city. Variables are like residents, some live in specific neighborhoods, that is local, some roam freely throughout the city, that is global, and others have temporary quarters within specified buildings, that is code blocks. Scopes define where these variables resident can be found and accessed. So, with that in mind, now let's break down each of these types of scopes in JavaScript. Starting with number one, global scope. In JavaScript, global scope is the widest scope available. Variables declared in global scope are accessible from anywhere in your code, whether it's inside functions, conditional statements, loops, or other blocks of code. You may think of global scope as the entire city. It's the most unrestricted area, and they can be accessed from anywhere in your code. Like a city landmark everyone knows. For example, town's central square. Everything you declare in global scope is like putting a billboard in the square for everyone to see. Any function or code block within your program can read and modify these global variables. Here's an example of global scope. Further, a word of caution. Global variables are convenient for quick access, but overuse can lead to naming conflicts and make your code harder to reason about. That's why it is generally recommended to use them sparingly. Moreover, global variables can make your code less modular and organized. Just imagine if everything is in the town square, it becomes challenging to manage and isolate different aspects of your code or program. Here are some best practices for using global scope. Number one, use global scope sparingly, as we should only declare variables in global scope when they genuinely need to be accessed globally. Number two, avoid overwriting global variables, as we need to be cautious when modifying global variables to prevent unintended side effects. Number three, use descriptive variable names. This helps us choose variable names that clearly convey their purpose, especially in global scope where they can affect many parts of your code. Next, number two, local scope. Now, local scope, also known as function scope, in JavaScript is like a private room within a building. It's an enclosed space where variables are only accessible from within that specific room. When you declare a variable in local scope, it is limited in visibility to the block of code, function, or conditional statement in which it is defined. Variables in local scope are protected from interference and modification by code outside their scope, thus providing a level of isolation. Consider this analogy. If a local scope is like a private room, a variable declared within that scope is similar to an object or a piece of furniture placed inside that room. Others can't directly interact with it from outside. They would need permission, like a key, to enter the room and then access the variable. Here's an example for the same. Now, based on what we know so far, let's understand the concept of variable shadowing. Now, variable shadowing occurs when you declare a variable with the same name inside a local scope, effectively hiding the variable with the same name in the higher scope. This is similar to placing an object with the same name in multiple rooms, and the one in the inner room takes precedence when you try to access it. Consider this example. In this code, the local variable message shadows the global variable with the same name when you are inside showMessage function. So, understanding local scope and how it provides encapsulation is a fundamental concept in JavaScript that allows for organized, modular, and less error-prone code. Next, number 3, block scope. Now, fundamentally, block scope is a stricter form of local scope and prevents accidental variable modification from outer scopes. Block scope in JavaScript is like a series of nested boxes within a large container, each with its own set of variables. Unlike global and local scopes, which are defined by functions or global context, block scope is created within specific code blocks such as conditional statements, if, else, switch, and loops like for, while. And here, variables are declared with let or const keywords inside a code block. Do note that these variables declared in the block scope are confined to that block and thus offer a high degree of isolation. To illustrate, imagine a Russian nesting doll. The larger doll represents the global scope and each smaller doll nested inside represents a block scope. Variables within a block scope can't escape to outer scopes, just as a doll within a doll cannot get out. Further, variables declared in block scope are only accessible within the block in which they are defined. These variables are like hidden treasures inside each nesting doll, known and accessible only within their respective compartments. I hope this analogy helps you. Here's an example using a block scope. In this code, block variable is defined within the block created by the if statement and is inaccessible outside of it. Next, let's understand the difference between block scope and local scope in JavaScript. So, block scope is often confused with local scope, but there's a key distinction. In local scope, variables are typically defined within a function, while block scope is created within code blocks like if, for, or while statements. Local scope is function level, meaning it encompasses the entire function, while block scope is limited to specific block where the variable is declared. Consider the following code to highlight the difference. In this example, local variable is accessible within the function because it's in local scope. On the other hand, block variable is accessible only within the if block due to the block scope. Now, block scope is a powerful tool for managing variable visibility and preventing unintended variable clashes within the specific code block. It enhances code modularity and helps you write more maintainable and predictable JavaScript code. And understanding block scope is essential for efficient and organized coding. Next is a very important concept of scope chain. Well, the scope chain in JavaScript is like a stack of transparent sheets, each representing a different scope. These sheets are stacked on top of each other, with the global scope at the bottom. When you reference a variable, JavaScript searches for it starting from the top, which in most cases is the current local or block scope, and moves down through the sheets looking in each scope until it finds the variable. This process of searching for variables through multiple scopes is known as scope chain. Further, the search stops as soon as the variable is found in any of the scopes in the chain, and variables with the same name in the outer scopes are shadowed by variables with the same name in the inner scopes. The scope chain helps avoid naming conflict by prioritizing variables within the current function and its closer scopes. Next, now that we know the fundamental types of scopes in JavaScript, let's learn about their best practices. So, to avoid common scope-related issues, we must 1. Limit global variables. 2. Use strict mode. Now, strict mode helps catch common programming mistakes and unsafe actions, including accidentally creating global variables. to enable script mode in JavaScript, add the following line to the top of your scripts. Number 3, avoid variable shadowing, as we need to be cautious when reusing variable names in nested scopes, as this can lead to confusion and unexpected behavior. Use descriptive variable names and minimize shadowing to improve code readability as well. Number 4, descriptive naming. This practice is essentially crucial in global scope where variable names can affect multiple parts of your code. Descriptive names improve code understanding and maintainability as well. Lastly, in conclusion, I'd like to say that scope in JavaScript is a fundamental concept that influences the behavior and structure of your code. Understanding the intricacies of global, local, and block scope, as well as the scope chain, is essential for becoming a proficient JavaScript developer. Do keep in mind that scope is not just a technical aspect of programming, it also plays a pivotal role in writing code that is both reliable and scalable. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you like my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.